What's going on, world? You now tuned in with FactsRemain.com. I'm your boy Lee Beats. I'm from Queens, New York, like Hollis, Jamaica area. I'm responsible for French Montana's Pop That, featuring Drake, Wayne, Ross. Also, I produced Kidding, Is It You? That's on his first album, so yeah. My creative process, I guess it depends on the day, the time. I never really have a set, like, it's different every day. I'll start something with the drums, I'll start something with, like, a few chords. It's never really the same. It just always changes, you know, like, and I gotta be influenced. If I'm not influenced, I can't really create as good as I would want to, so that's about it. Some of my musical influence are, I would have to say, like, Pharrell, Ryan Leslie. Yeah, Pharrell, Ryan Leslie, Swiss Beats. The record came about, it's kind of funny, like somebody played some music for me, and it just all came together. I had the idea, I made the beat, and then a few months, maybe not even months, like a few weeks after, somebody contacted me, gave me an email, Chinx Drugs, he's part of Coke Boys. I sent the beat to him, and from there it was over. He gave the beat to French, and I didn't think it was going to be a single, but that's what it is. I was surprised when I found out it was going to be a lead single. I mean, you work for stuff like this, so when it happens, I mean, it happens. You're gonna be happy for it. I'm grateful for it. So, you know, that's about it. I haven't heard the record on the radio yet, honestly. I don't listen to radio that much, but a lot of people text me. They call me like, yo, your joint is on the radio. Your joint is in the club, strip clubs. So, that's about it. It was dope getting the shout out from Elliot Wilson. You know, like, a lot of people know him. He's great for what he do. I mean, it was just like, it's all a blessing, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's not, I really don't know how to feel about all of this yet until, like, I'm further along, you know what I'm saying? Like, right now it's still fresh, but give me, like, another 2 years. I'll know exactly how to feel, you know what I'm saying? It opens a lot of doors for me, you know what I'm saying? Because it's a lot of managers, a lot of artists reaching out. It just created more opportunities for what I really want to do, you know what I'm saying? I'm still trying to get more work on French album, honestly. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to get more work on French album. I want to get something on Big Sean's album. Who else? I mean, anybody. Everybody that's dope, I want to work with. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's nobody I don't want to work with. Like, a dream collaboration, I would have to say Jay. Jay and Kanye. Eminem. I would love to collaborate with like a Swiss or like a Dre or somebody like that. That would be dope. Or, you know, Pharrell, Ryan Leslie, collabs. Yeah, those are the main people that I could say. Well, I actually reached out to Fab, and he took, like, I think he liked about two records that I know he liked. One, I think he wrote to. And my manager, Skane, he told me that they were getting calls from, like, Akon and Melody Fiona and stuff like that. So, I mean, I'm just ready to work with whoever and whenever. I look at what's going on outside of Queens, because that's what I like. I want to reach people outside of Queens. I mean, I got my borough, but I want other boroughs, other cities, other countries. So, you know, I'm influenced by just good music, period. Like I said, good music, wherever it's from. It don't got to be from Queens. It could be from wherever. And just hit me on Twitter. I respond to damn near everybody on Twitter. So Twitter is basically it. Just ask me for my email, number, whatever. Just hit me. My Twitter is at Lee on the Beats. My Gmail is my Gmail is Lee on the Beats. Everything, just hit me, Lee on the Beats. Facebook, Lee on the Beats. Twitter, Lee on the Beats. Gmail.